Moroto District is estimated to have a total of 813,079 livestock, of which 75,278 have been vaccinated against various diseases, including goat pox.
We have about 300,000 head of cattle, about 200,000 sheep, 234,000 goats. We also have donkeys, about 1,000, chicken, about 55,000, turkeys, about 1,500, dogs, also inclusive, 2,400, among others. We also have camels at 2,000, and pigs at about 2,000 also. Ducks at about 3,700, and pigeons at about 925.
The Commissioner for Animal Health in the Ministry of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries, Dr. Rose Ademone, has noted that Uganda is about to start its own vaccines for animals.
Animal Research Organization, NARO, they are working on vaccines. We also have Makerere University, they are working on vaccines. The specific vaccines they are working on are the vaccines against ticks. Vaccines that you will inject on the body, and the body of the animal rejects the tick. So when the animal, when the tick climbs and bites the animal, their mouth parts can fall off and the tick falls off. So those are the type of vaccines we are working on.
The Minister for Animal Industry, Honorable Bright Remirama, said that they want to establish feeds to ensure that animals feed well and produce good quality meat and milk for export.
Because the dairy industry here is still very low, we are pushing it. We have a regional office already established. It will take some time because people must adapt. These cows you have seen, they are not good milkers, but they can provide very good beef. And we are talking to the leadership. We want to establish feedlots so that now we can have meat ready for export, or even livestock for export.
The minister has urged residents in Karamoja to embrace government programs in order to improve their livelihoods. He has encouraged the leaders to cluster the people into cooperatives so that they can get government support.
We need to change the mindset of the people, and that's why we are here. We are talking to the NGO world that they need to change the approach. If they have to work with us, they must fit in government programs so that we empower these communities to be on their own. Karamoja is not actually a very barren land as one would imagine. You have seen around, the soils are fertile.
According to Ramirama, government is going to set up breeding centers in Abimu, Nakapiripit, Napak, and also set up learning centers in the community. Local leaders have applauded government for improving livestock in the Karamoja region.
Now that rustling has subsidized, has been controlled, we are going to establish in a bean breeding center that will be co-located with NARO. We are also going to establish another farm in Nakapiripirit and another one in Napak, provide breeds for those who want to go commercial so that they have stock here, and also there will be learning centers for the community.
Dr. Wellington Besong, the team leader for Food and Agriculture Organization in Uganda, has said that FAO is willing to help people in Karamoja have food security in the community. He has urged farmers to embrace commercial farming.
The mantra of the Ministry of Agriculture now, which I think is the vision of the government, to commercialize a given proportion of farms. The farms should move from peasant farms to farms that are targeting a given market. It will get to a point where the people of Uganda will aspire to export their products out of the country. And I think there's already a strong demand internationally. These products from these animals, if they must go to other countries, they must conform to certain standards.
Report compiled by Godfrey Sempija for the news.